We will start now with our first step into the beauty retouching. And the first thing I always do is that I actually develop the whole image in Adobe Camera Raw. A lot of people, they always say what's better, Adobe Camera Raw or Lightroom. That really depends a little bit onto your own workflow. I like Adobe Camera Raw because it lets you work kind of nicely together with Photoshop, because you can always go from Photoshop back into Camera Raw. But if you prefer Lightroom, you can obviously also do your developing there and then bring it into Photoshop. But if you are working in Adobe Camera Raw, I want to show you now a little trick that I really like. So the reason why we opened this image as a smart object is that you can easily now double click on the image, and it brings you back into Adobe Camera Raw, where you could change the adjustments. So you could just brighten it and bring it, I don't know, more contrast or something. And then you just say okay. And now you have your adjustments. But the problem is now, obviously, when you think the adjustments, they are too strong, you can't go in and lower the opacity, because now, obviously, then you have just a white paper coming through. So that doesn't really work. So whatever adjustment you would do now, that would be your final adjustment. So I want to just go back and not have it like this for now, and just show you another way how it's actually a lot better to work. So if you want to have now a new layer where you can do all your adjustments in Adobe Camera Raw, you can't actually do what you normally do, where you just go Command Control J and now you have a new layer. Or you might go over this bar, and there you could also go in and go for duplicate layer. But the problem is, if we go into the image now and say okay, we want this brighter, and say okay, and now you might think, okay, now I have my second layer, whatever I don't like, no problem, I can always reduce the opacity. But even if you go down all the way to zero, nothing happens. And the reason is because these are now connected, because actually this, even if it's now not toggled, the whole adjustment that you did went onto your original image. And I'm not sure why they do it like this. It's obviously not what I want. It doesn't make any sense. So I just go back a few steps and just say, yeah, don't want that. I want that this is like its own layer where I can do adjustments. So I will delete this, and I want to call this original. Because a real neat trick about this is that sometimes you might work on an image already in Adobe Camera Raw, and then you also do your adjustments in Photoshop. And in the end, when you then save everything and you go back into Bridge or wherever you saved the image and you compare it, you could be like, oh wow, actually that's now a lot different than the original image, maybe even too much. And you never really had any control, because if you change already your image in Adobe Camera Raw and then you open it up and you have all your all your adjustments on this image already, then it's really hard to judge. And if you now basically, if you want to do the Adobe Camera Raw development, you can now do it on another layer, but just leave this alone, because this way you can always just go back and see what did my original image really look like. So, but as we said, we can't just copy it and then do the adjustments, because then it still changed the original image. What we will do now is that we go with a right mouse click onto this layer, and from there we will say that we need a new smart object, but via copy. That is important. So, and now if you click back into the image, double click will just bring you back into Raw, and you go in and say, okay, I want this whole image really bright, and you click okay. Now you see that you can lower the opacity. And this is really great, because now you could be okay, I leave it like at 25, and my original image is still the original image, nothing changed. And now you can do all sorts of other adjustments, and whatever you want to change, you can always just click with Alt or Option on here and untoggle all of these above, and you will always see the original image. So just to recap, in case you didn't quite understand, because it is a little bit tricky, especially if you're a beginner. If you wouldn't click, let's say we want to open this one. So, and let's say now in our workflow box here, you don't have this tick on, so you have this empty where it says smart object. And then it also says here not open object, but it will say open image. And you could say, okay, I do now my first development. I want this a bit brighter, more contrast, highlights down, shadow up, white, black, clarity. And I want this really warm. Okay, like that. And then you open the image. Okay, and now you see, you don't have this little box here. So this is only, yeah, now your image where you would work on. So if you double click, instead that it opens up in Adobe Camera Raw, it just tells you now a new layer. So you could now have, instead of the background layer, which is locked, if I would press now OK, this lock button goes away. And I have now my free layer zero. But it didn't help me. Now I obviously can't go back into Adobe Camera Raw. And whatever other adjustments I will do now on top of this one, I can never see in Photoshop, how did my original image look like? And how much, could I potentially go overboard with that? So therefore, if you are kind of, maybe still new to Photoshop, or if you just want more control, then it makes a lot of sense if you open your image the first time just as a smart object, but without changing anything. And then you can go in and do all your adjustments on the second layer here, but just make sure it will not work if you just duplicate the layer. You have to do the right mouse click and you have to go into this new smart object via copy, and this is the only way how this will be on its own. And then you can even go in again and say, okay, if we bring this back into 100 and you didn't really like it, you don't have to change the opacity. You could also go in now and say, nee, I went a bit overboard with my exposure, and now we could also just do the development how I would do it.